Every year, thousands of RV'ers hit the road thinking they're ready to tow. But towing isn't just about horsepower, it's about physics. And when you get it wrong, even a small mistake can turn your setup into a 60-mile-an-hour wrecking ball. Today, we're counting down the top 10 most dangerous towing mistakes RV'ers make, and how to avoid every single one. Some are simple oversights. Others are silent problems that build over time. Stick around, because mistake number one is the one that flips the most trailers every single year. Let's get started. Number 10, ignoring your tow ratings. Every truck and trailer combo has a limit, but too many RVers treat those numbers like suggestions. Your gross vehicle weight rating, or GVWR, your gross combined weight rating, GCWR, and your tongue weight aren't just engineer jargon. They're to keep you safe. Overloading your tow vehicle doesn't just hurt the transmission. It changes how your entire rig handles. Braking, cornering, and sway resistance all drop fast. Maybe you're thinking, it's only a few hundred pounds over. What's the big deal? The big deal is that once your truck is maxed out, every curve, crosswind, and emergency stop becomes a gamble. If your payload sticker says 1,800 pounds, and your hitch, passengers, and tongue weight add up to 1,900 pounds, you're already outside the safety margin. Before you ever hitch up, weigh your rig. Know your real numbers. Because when it comes to towing, close enough doesn't cut it. Number 9, incorrect hitch setup. You can have the perfect truck and trailer and still lose control if your WDH isn't set correctly. A weight distribution hitch balances your rig so both axles share the load. If the bars aren't tensioned right, the rear of your truck squats, your headlights point toward the sky, and your front tires lose grip. Steering gets loose. Braking distance grows. People love to eyeball it. Looks level, must be fine. But it's not about looks, it's about leverage. Set it up properly. Measure the height of your fenders before and after you tension the bars. Adjust until your front end settles close to its original height. It takes 20 minutes. It could save your life. Number 8, loading too much weight behind the axle. Maybe you toss a generator, a cooler, or bikes in the back because there's room. But that rear weight acts like a pendulum. Every bump and gust of wind makes it swing wider. Trailer sway starts small, a gentle side-to-side motion. Then one overcorrection later, the sway doubles, and within seconds, it's out of control. Keep heavy items low and forward. Aim for about 10 to 15% of your trailer's total weight on the hitch. That one habit prevents more sway accidents than any gadget on the market. Number 7, skipping the brake controller setup. If you tow anything over 3,000 pounds, your trailer brakes are your best friend, if they're tuned right. Too many RVers plug in their brake controller and never touch it again. If the gain is too low, your truck does all the work, overheats pads, and loses braking power. If it's too high, the trailer locks up and starts steering the truck. Every load is different. Adjust your brake controller for each trip. Start at a middle setting, drive about 20 miles per hour, and apply the manual brake. Your trailer should slow the truck smoothly, not jerk it. 5 minutes of setup can prevent a disaster when traffic stops suddenly ahead. Number 6, neglecting tire pressure and tire age. Tire blowouts don't happen suddenly. They build quietly, from low pressure, overloading, or sun damage. RV tires live a brutal life, long sits, heavy loads, and ultraviolet heat. Most failures come from age, not mileage. 5 to 7 years is about all you get, even if they look fine. Underinflated tires flex too much, build heat, and fail fast. Overinflated tires lose traction and ride rough. Use a TPMS, a tire pressure monitoring system, and check your cold pressures before every trip. Your tires are the only thing connecting your 10,000-pound home to the highway. Treat them like it. Number 5, setting tongue weight. Tongue weight controls everything about how your rig behaves. Too little, and your trailer fishtails. Too much, and your truck squats. Most RVs need about 10 to 15% of their total weight on the hitch. If your trailer weighs 8,000 pounds, your tongue weight should land between 800 and 1,200. You can't guess this by eye. Use a tongue scale or visit a CAT scale at a truck stop. Getting this one number right can turn a nerve-wracking drive into a calm cruise. Number 4, speeding downhill or in crosswinds. Speed feels fine, until it isn't. A downhill stretch or a strong crosswind can turn a stable setup into chaos in seconds. Once a trailer starts to sway, speed magnifies every movement. Most drivers instinctively accelerate to straighten it out. That's the worst thing you can do. Slow down before the hill, downshift early, and let your engine braking do the work. When winds pick up, especially in open plains or mountain passes, drop to 55 or even 45 miles per hour. It's not about ego, it's about control. Every mile per hour you shed gives your trailer less energy to fight you with. Number 3. Wrong hitch height or mismatched setup. Your hitch height determines your entire rig's stability, and it's one of the easiest details to overlook. If your trailer rides nose high, your rear axle carries too much weight and braking power drops. If it rides nose low, tongue weight spikes and sway increases. Even a 2-inch difference can change how your trailer tracks behind you. When you hitch up, make sure your trailer sits level. Measure from the ground to the bottom of the coupler when loaded. Then match that on your hitch ball. And if you change trucks or trailers, remeasure everything. What was perfect last season might be dangerous this one. Number 2. Underestimating stopping distance. A loaded RV rig can weigh 3 or 4 times what your truck alone weighs. That means your stopping distance isn't just longer, it's exponential. At 60 miles per hour, a half-ton truck might need about 130 feet to stop. Add a 9,000-pound trailer, and you'll need well over 250. If you follow too closely, you've already lost. Keep at least 7 seconds of space between you and the vehicle ahead. Plan every stop before it happens. Ease off early. Brake gently. Keep both hands steady. In towing, anticipation beats reaction every single time. Number 1. Not knowing what to do when the trailer starts to sway. This is the big one, and it's the one that surprises even experienced RVers. You're driving straight. Everything feels fine. Then a gust of wind hits, or a passing semi-truck sends a wave of air and suddenly the trailer starts to wiggle. At first, it's minor. You think you can steer it out. Don't. Steering or braking hard makes it worse. Fast. The correct move is counterintuitive. Take your foot off the gas, don't touch the brakes, and let the rig slow naturally. If you have a brake controller with a manual override, apply gentle trailer-only braking to pull it straight. Once it settles, pull over, take a breath, and figure out why it happened. Weight balance, tire pressure, hitch height, or wind. Something caused it. Trailer sway gives you seconds to react. Know your move before it starts. Safe towing isn't luck. It's preparation. It's knowing your numbers, setting up your rig correctly, and respecting the weight you're pulling. Every mistake on this list has put real people in danger, but every one of them is preventable. If you double-check your setup, monitor your tires, and drive like every mile matters, you'll avoid 99% of towing disasters before they begin. Safe towing isn't about getting there faster. It's about getting there in one piece. If this video helped you out, hit subscribe for more real RV tips, towing breakdowns, and lessons from the road. Travel smart, stay steady, and we'll see you down the highway.